Israel says it will consider a very serious proposal to extend its truce with Hamas militants in Gaza. The six-day pause in fighting ended Wednesday. Talks are ongoing for another potential extension, but there's no word yet if a deal has been reached.
The current framework allows for a few more days of hostage release pause, but in as much as there is a serious offer on the table to release the remaining hostages as we are demanding, we will of course consider every serious proposal because we're committed to doing everything to bring them back. The IDF continues to use this hostage release pause to strengthen our preparations and approve battle plans for the continuation of the war to destroy Hamas in response to the October 7th massacre, and we will continue when Hamas stops releasing hostages.
The United Nations support Israel's call for the release of all hostages being held by Hamas, but it also demands a safe and unimpeded humanitarian access to Gaza.
The people of Gaza are in the midst of an epic humanitarian catastrophe before the eyes of the world. We must not look away. Intense negotiations are taking place to prolong the truce, which we strongly welcome. But we believe we need a true humanitarian ceasefire.
Israel and Hamas also reportedly seeking a new truce agreement, which could see the release of men and military personnel being held in Gaza. Currently, only Israeli women and children are being freed, along with some foreign nationals. A longer ceasefire also likely on the table. Despite the plan, Israel maintains it will not back down on its fight against Hamas.
At the start of the war, I set three goals: eliminating Hamas, returning all of our hostages, and ensuring that Gaza will never again go back to being a threat to Israel. These three goals still stand. The past week, we have had a very great achievement: the return of dozens of our hostages. A week ago, this seemed imaginary, but we achieved it. But in recent days, I have heard a question. After completing this stage of the return of our hostages, will Israel go back to the fighting? My answer is an unequivocal yes. There is no situation in which we do not go back to fighting until the end.
Talks between Israel and Hamas to extend the truce in Gaza were overshadowed by an unconfirmed claim that a 10-month-old baby and his family had been killed. The military wing of Hamas said the youngest hostage was killed in an earlier Israeli bombing, along with his 4-year-old and brother and their mother. Israel says it's assessing the accuracy of the claim. The baby's family is among the most high-profile hostages of Hamas. Israeli officials met with their relatives to inform them about the claims of the group. Two Russian hostages freed from Hamas captivity. The group says the release was done in response to a request from the Russian leadership. Meanwhile, the Red Cross confirmed it facilitated the release of 16 captives Wednesday. They were handed over to Israeli authorities and have arrived safely in Rafah. Israel says around 160 hostages are still being held by Hamas. One of the Filipino hostages freed by Hamas looking to return to the Philippines for good. Jimmy Pacheco is now in a hotel in Israel, days after being discharged from the hospital. He also plans to return to Manila for the holidays. Meanwhile, Loraline Babadilla, the last Filipino hostage freed by Hamas, is currently at a hospital where she is undergoing medical evaluation. So far, more than 400 Filipinos in the Middle East have been repatriated since the war erupted. Only 26 remain in the Gaza Strip. Meanwhile, 17 Filipino seafarers are still held captive by Houthi groups in Yemen. But the Philippine government assures the public of their safety.
So far, the Houthis have not requested anything, nor have they wanted to touch base with governments. So that's the issue. The seafarers are in a ship somewhere in Houthi-controlled territory in the south of Yemen.
Okay, but they're safe.
So far they're safe, yes. But of course, any additional day is something we're concerned about.
The spike in respiratory illnesses in China is now under control. That's according to Chinese Foreign Minister Wang Yi. He adds China's interactions with the international community will not be affected by the spike in flu cases. He also says China will continue to welcome visitors from other countries. Last week, the WHO, or World Organization, asked China to provide detailed information on the increase in cases of respiratory illnesses and pneumonia, especially among children. But the WHO noted the increase is not as high as before the COVID-19 pandemic and that there are no unusual pathogens found in the recent cases. Well, let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, here are news making headlines for Filipinos in North America. We begin with the United States Ambassador to the United Nations expressing hope that a truce in Gaza can be extended.
We're hopeful that the truce can be extended, but as I said in the council, this is all in the hands of Hamas. The Israelis have said if they continue to release 10 hostages a day, they will extend by a day. So it truly is, it is in their hands, but I do think there is a potential for that. And we're actively working to extend the deal.
United States Ambassador to the United Nations Linda Thomas-Greenfield says they are continuing to work to get American hostages and all hostages released from the clutches of Hamas and other groups.
Two Americans have already been released, and we are hoping to get all of the hostages, all of the Americans out.
Hamas gunmen reportedly seized 240 people during a rampage into southern Israel on October 7, in which they killed 1,200 people. Israel's bombardment of Gaza in retaliation has killed more than 15,000 Gazans, according to health authorities in the Palestinian enclave. In other news, we meet Isabel Jurado, who's looking to be the first Filipina in the LA City Council. Isabel Jurado and her family started from humble beginnings. A daughter of a formerly undocumented worker, the Los Angeles-born and raised Filipina became a mom at a young age. She eventually graduated from UCLA Law School and now works as an eviction attorney. She is making a run for the Los Angeles City Council and hopes to be the first Filipina to win the post.
I think that's the experience that we need in City Hall, real life lived experience, professional experience on the front lines of the most pressing issues. And I think it's time that we have, you know, a Filipino in the seat, a woman, and representing this district who just is a real person.
The 35-year-old attorney is hoping to represent the 14th district that has faced controversy in recent years. The incumbent is Kevin De Leon, who had been embroiled in a leaked audio recording of him and other council members making racial remarks during a redistricting meeting. He survived a recall earlier this year.
And finally, hats off to a Filipino teacher who was just chosen as one of California's Teachers of the Year.
This robot can swallow and shoot balls in the air, while this robot can pick up cones and stack them. They were all designed and built by students here at Ignacio Valley High School in Concord, California. Their teacher is Filipino Joseph Alvarico, who has over 20 years of experience as an educator.
Malaking karangalan para ako'y mabansagan na isa sa limang California Teachers of the Year. Kasi, for one, ako lang po ang napili dito sa Northern California. And pangalawa, ako lang po ang Filipino na napili out of the many Filipino teachers na nandito rin po na nagtuturo dito sa California.
I think this is what he does to get students to really start to think about what they want to do in life. And I believe that is the very aspect of his personality that really builds the students into leaders.
And those are the news-making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.